This is Little Jimmy Hopkins. Today, he's going to learn 10 amazing things about Asian Americans. Hello there, Little Jimmy. Going to Chinatown, eh? Well, before you go on your merry way, would you like to learn 10 amazing things about Asian Americans? Well, tough luck, Jimmy. I believe you have no choice. To Chinatown. Here we are, Jimmy. Go ahead, take a look around. Watch your back. Anyway, Jimmy, Chinatown was a home to many of the early Chinese immigrants. In the 1850s, Chinese migrants built a Chinatown. Chinatown was built out of survival by the Chinese immigrants because of the racism that they faced. They were not welcome in the white neighborhoods. The same can be said about the Japanese and Koreans who built their own towns in America. These towns offered low-class jobs and the freedom to practice their culture within the safety of their community. Let's learn about why these Asians came to America in the first place. So you're wondering why you need to learn this? Well, because Jimmy, Eurocentric history serves no one, and you don't want to be an ignorant Eurocentric white guy, do you, Jimmy? I didn't think so. Watch your step, Jimmy. Oh, Jimmy, Jimmy, Jimmy. Now get back up and dust yourself off, because we have a long way to go. Well, Jimmy, do you know where Asian Americans came from? That's right, Jimmy, the Far East. And do you know why they came here? Well, Jimmy, that's only one part of the story. You see, for the Chinese, they had their lands taken away from them, and the civil war in China made it an unsafe place to stay. Many were so poor in the end that they had no choice but to sell themselves to the Americans. The Chinese saw America as Gold Mountain, and by immigrating to America, they would be able to accumulate enough wealth to return back to China and regain the property that they lost. The Japanese came to America with a role of an ambassador to promote goodwill between the two countries. Some also immigrated with the purpose of accumulating further wealth. Korea, on the other hand, had a different dilemma, for their home country was being colonized by the Japanese. Many fled to America for their safety, while others came to organize resistance groups hoping to free their nation from Japanese oppressions. While these Asians came to America for a better life, it didn't necessarily turn out that way, for you see, they had to endure the hardships of being discriminated. They faced both individual and institutional discrimination. For individual discrimination, they were spat on, rocks were thrown at them, and constantly received racial insults. While for institutional discrimination, they faced issues like miners' tax that were directed specifically at the Chinese, anti-miscegenation laws, and the inability to apply for citizenship. Turn around, Jimmy. You see that suspicious-looking Asian guy? You may think he's more loyal to China, but in fact, he's more patriotic than you. And he likes playing America's favorite pastime, baseball. Go Giants! Not only does he play baseball, he also plays football. Not soccer football, American football. He studies American history, plays American video games, and believes in the First Amendment. Watching Bruce Lee and Chuck Norris, Jimmy? That's very interesting. Did you know that most Americans think that Asian males have training in the martial arts? Hold your horses, Jimmy. This is not true. This is what we call a stereotype. Stereotype is a generalization of one's ethnicity. If stereotypes become too widely accepted, this can cause serious problems. Let's take a look at the classroom. Here we have Steven, who is about to solve a very difficult math problem. This is a very popular stereotype. The stereotype that Asians are good at math and do extremely well in school. They get perfect scores on their exams, many are prodigies at the piano violin, they are well behaved, and obey the law. The term for this stereotype is the model minority. The effects of this stereotype can be devastating. Why? Because this marginalizes all the Asians, which results in the government to believe that all Asians are well off and do not need any sort of assistance from them. While in fact not all Asians follow the model minority stereotype, and thus they suffer from higher rates of stress, depression, mental illness, and suicide attempts in comparison to other groups. Don't all ages look the same to you, Jimmy? Well, this is false. Here we have three different Asians. A Chinese, a Japanese, and a Korean. If you group them together as one, it'd be a great insult to them. Each Asian ethnicity has their own unique culture ranging from languages, religion, food, and history. By generalizing and grouping Asians together as one destroys their identity. Would you like your race to be generalized into one group? I didn't think so. While Asian Americans faced many hardships during their stay in America, they were not always victims. The Asian Americans has had their share of agents who have fought back against oppression. For example, the Chinese Six Company, who fought for the rights of Chinese Americans. Korematsu, who stood up against unfair accusations that faced the Japanese Americans during World War II. Finally, we get to the contributions of Asian Americans.
You seem hungry, Jimmy. That's alright, Jimmy. Hold out your hand. This is a steamed pork bun, also known as a cha su bao, one of the many contributions Asian Americans has given to the Americans.
These contributions include the Japanese, who converted California desert land into fertile land perfect for agriculture. The Chinese, who built the Transcontinental Railroad and connected east from west and allowed this nation to continue to prosper. They fought in our military during World War II and died proudly along their fellow Americans.
Gee, you have learned a lot, haven't you? What's that, Jimmy? You plan to take an Asian studies class? That's great, Jimmy. If there are more people like you, the world would be a better place.